Chapter 4, The World of Metals and Non-Metals, Question Answers from Grade 7, Subject Science, Book Curiosity. Let us enhance our learning. Question 1, which metal is commonly used to make food packaging materials as it is cheaper and its thin sheets can be folded easily into any shape? Answer. First, aluminium. Reason, aluminium is malleable, lightweight and cheaper than many other metals. Question 2. Which of the following metal catches fire when it comes in contact with water? Answer. 4th. Sodium. Sodium reacts very quickly and violently with water and oxygen, so it is stored in kerosene. Question 3. State with reasons whether the following statements are true, T, or false, F. First, aluminium and copper are examples of non-metals used for making utensils and statues. So friends, this is false. Reason, aluminium and copper are metals, not non-metals. Second, metals form oxides when combined with oxygen, the solution of which turns blue litmus paper to red. So friends, this is also false. Reason, metal oxides are basic in nature. They turn red litmus paper to blue. Next, third, oxygen is a non-metal essential for respiration. So friends, this is true. Reason, we need oxygen to breathe and survive. It is a very important non-metal. Fourth, copper vessels are used for boiling water because they are good conductors of electricity. So friends, this is false. Reason, copper vessels are used for boiling water because they are good conductors of heat, not electricity. Question 4. Why are only a few metals suitable for making jewellery? Answer. Only a few metals like gold and silver are used in jewellery because they are lustrous, malleable, ductile and do not corrode easily. Other metals may be too reactive or not attractive enough. Question 5. Match the uses of metals and non-metals given in column 1st with the jumbled names of metals and non-metals given in column 2. So friends, I have already written the names of metals and non-metals which were jumbled. Now let's match them. Used in electrical wiring. Answer C, copper. Second, most malleable and ductile. Answer E, gold. Third, living organisms cannot survive without it. Answer A, oxygen. Fourth, plants grow healthy when fertilizers containing it are added to the soil. Answer D, nitrogen. Fifth, used in water purification. Answer C, chlorine. So friends, you can match them accordingly. Question 6. What happens when oxygen reacts with magnesium and sulfur? What are the main differences in the nature of products formed? Answer. Magnesium reacts with oxygen to form magnesium oxide, which is basic in nature. Sulfur reacts with oxygen to form sulfur dioxide, which forms acidic sulfurous acid in water. So, metal oxides are basic and non-metal oxides are acidic. Question 7. Complete the following flowchart. Here comes magnesium ribbon plus air plus heat. We get ash. Then we add water. We get magnesium hydroxide solution. Add blue and red litmus solution separately. Change in red litmus solution, blue. This shows the solution is basic. And change in blue litmus solution, blue. Because the solution is basic, the blue litmus solution will not change its color. Question 8. You are provided with the following materials. Discuss which material would be your choice to make a pen that is most suitable for boiling water and why. Answer. Copper. Reason. Copper is a good conductor of heat, strong and doesn't react quickly with water or air, making it ideal for boiling water. Question 9. You are provided with 3 iron nails, each dipped in oil, water and vinegar. Which iron nail will not rust and why? Answer. The nail dipped in oil will not rust. Reason. Oil prevents both air and moisture from coming in contact with iron, stopping rusting. Question 10. How do the different properties of metals and non-metals determine their uses in everyday life? Answer. Metals are strong, shiny, malleable, ductile, and good conductors. So they are used in tools, utensils, wires, machines, etc. Non-metals are essential in life processes like oxygen, used in fertilizers, nitrogen, and purification, chlorine, despite being dull and brittle. Question 11. One of the methods of protecting iron from getting rusted is to put a thin coating of zinc metal over it. Since sulfur does not react with water, can it be used for this purpose? Justify your answer. Answer: No, sulfur cannot be used. Reason: Sulfur is a non-metal and brittle, and it does not form a protective coating. Zinc is used because it is metallic and protective. Question 12. An ironsmith heats iron before making tools. Why is heating necessary in this process? Answer: Heating makes iron soft and easier to shape. When hot, it can be beaten or molded into tools like axes and spades. Next, exploratory projects. Dhokra, Bidriware, Pembarthi, and Kamrupi are some of India's famous metal art styles. Find out the states where these artworks are made. Also make a collage of their photographs. Answer: Metal art styles, Dhokra, Chhattisgarh, Bidriware, Karnataka, Pembarthi, Telangana, Kamrupi, Assam. So friends, make a collage of these beautiful artworks with photos and state names. So you have to do this yourself. Next question. On a map of India, mark the states where iron, gold, aluminium, and other metals are found. Answer: Metal mining in India. Mark states on a map where iron, Odisha, gold, Karnataka, aluminium, Jharkhand are found. So friends, you have to mark Odisha in the map for iron, Karnataka for gold, and Jharkhand for aluminium in India's map. So you have to do this yourself. Next, explore the metals and non-metals found in smartphones and find out how they help the phone work properly. Answer: Metals in smartphones. Metals like aluminium, copper, lithium, gold, non-metals like carbon, graphite in batteries. These help in screens, circuits, and batteries. Next, organize a classroom debate on whether the use of metals for comfort and luxury should be increased or decreased. Answer: Classroom debate topic, should we increase or decrease the use of metals for luxury and comfort? Pros: Convenience, development. Cons: Resource depletion, pollution. So friends, you can debate on these points in your class. And with this, we have completed all the question answers. From Chapter 4, The World of Metals and Non-Metals, we have already studied the short notes and summary of this chapter. You can find the link in the description and on the screen. If you like the video, kindly like it and share it with your friends. Also, subscribe to my channel. We will meet in the next video. Thank you for watching.